In this screencast, we're going to talk about a specific case of diffusion, and we're going to stage this by asking a question first. So let's take a look at these two tanks in which we have a species A and species B. In the way I've drawn them, blue doesn't necessarily represent species A and yellow doesn't represent species B. Those are just the two mixtures in both tank 1 and tank 2. And they are closed off by a valve here in the middle that separates them from making contact. We know that the temperature is constant for the system, that it's a closed system, and that the pressure is going to remain constant. So I've defined positive Z from left to right, and we have two points of interest, Z1 and Z2, which are the entrances to both tanks. The mole fraction of A and B in tank 1 is written as YA1 and YB1, and the same for tank 2, YA2 and YB2. We're told that based on our mixtures, the mole fraction of A in tank 1 is greater than that in tank 2, and the mole fraction of B in tank 2 is greater than that in tank 1. When this system is opened and the mixtures come in contact with each other, which of the following statements is false? A, there will be a net flux of A to the right. B, the net flux of B is 0. C, the magnitude of the net flux of A is equal to that of B. Or D, the net flux of A is opposite in direction to the net flux of B. So we know that since we have a concentration gradient for A going from Z1 to Z2, that we're going to go from a higher concentration to a lower concentration. So we would expect A to move to the right. So we know that part A of the question must be true and therefore is not one of the answers. We also know that the same must be true for B, that since we have a higher concentration of B on the right side, that we're going to have a flux of B from the right to the left. So therefore, at least we know that B must be false. Now the magnitude of the net flux of A is equal to that of B. So we're saying here that NA must equal the magnitude of NB. So what do we know about our system? Since temperature and pressure are constant, we're working with gases, we know that the overall concentration must be constant in our system. So if the net flux of A was not equal in magnitude to the net flux of B, we would get some kind of buildup of these gases in part of our system, and therefore our concentration couldn't be kept constant. We'd have a pressure gradient, and we know that that can't happen here since it's a closed system. So the magnitude of the A must be equal to the B, and not only that, it must be in the opposite direction of B. Therefore, we're saying that the net molar flux of A is equal and opposite in direction to the net molar flux of B. Now, this special case where we have the net flux of A equal and opposite to the net flux of B in a closed system is called equimolar counterdiffusion, or EMD for short. So what's this mean for our two constitutive equations that we worked out in previous screencast for our net fluxes? Recall that the net molar flux of A was equal to our diffusive flux plus our mass transfer due to bulk flow. Now in this case, we're saying that our net flux N is equal to NA plus NB, since we have a binary system, and NA is equal to negative NB, so this must be equal to 0. This means that the net molar flux of A is just equal to the diffusive flux of A, in this case, JA. This also means the same for B, and therefore, by relationship, the diffusive fluxes must be equal and opposite. So what's this mean? If we were to look at the molar flux of A, and we have a binary mixture in which the total concentration is constant, the pressure, temperature, constant, and the mole fractions are constant, so we have a steady state process, but different between two points like we have above, between point Z1 and Z2, then we could write this simply as the following. So now this becomes the equation we use to characterize steady state equimolar counterdiffusion. So if we wanted to plot what the mole fraction versus Z looks like, if we go from Z1 to Z2, we know that the mole fraction of A is going to decrease from point Z1 to Z2. same is true for XB, but we're starting on Z2 side and going down. One last thing to point out with this binary system is if we know that the flux of A must be equal and opposite to the flux of B, does this also mean that the diffusivity of AB is equal to the negative diffusivity of BA? Well, we know that the concentration is constant, and this is equal to the concentration of A plus the concentration of B. And so if we were to differentiate this, we know that there's no change in concentration, so we could write it as the following. This implies that the differential of the concentration of A is equal to the negative differential of the concentration of B. And we know what our flux equations look like. In this case, we know that JA is equal to negative JB. So therefore, that means we have the following relationship. If the distances we're looking at are the same, then we can just remove them and therefore show that the diffusion coefficients are not equal and opposite, as we had with the fluxes, but in fact, the equality is that the diffusion coefficient for A and B is the same as the diffusion coefficient for B and A. And this will be true every time we have equimolar diffusion for a binary system. In another screencast, we'll apply this to an example problem.